crystal that we are looking at. You heard of sea level rise, right? What does it mean? That there are islands which will be disappearing from the face of this earth. Bangladesh has got a very high population. Some parts of Bangladesh are coastal regions. I mean, the prediction is in another 100 years, even half of Bombay will be disappearing, right? And if you look at the world, 80% of the global population lives within 200 kilometers from the coast. So what will happen to these people? Where will they go? So this mass migration will be another big problem that you have to be prepared. Then, resources. Now look at this. Indian Ocean region is the hub for energy security. Where does this energy come from? From the Middle East? All the oil and gas comes from there? And where does it go maximum? To our east? China, Hong Kong, Japan, Korea, these are the maximum consumers of oil and gas or the energy. So this area has become very, very important. So the entire global energy security is driven by here. So it also becomes very vulnerable for us. If there is disturbance in your backyard, you are not safe. Right? The second is food security. Now we are increasingly looking at the oceans or the water for food security. Because the biomass that it generates and the protein that it can provide to feed the masses can only come from the water. But are you aware that since 1996, the fish stock globally is on the decline? But on the other side, the bycatch, what is the bycatch? Anybody knows? When we put this big nets, everything gets collected, but what you consume is only few species. You don't eat every type of fish, right? So what you consume and what you throw out, that ratio, that is called bycatch. I mean, what you wanted and what you threw, that is called bycatch. The bycatch today is on the order of 80%. 80%. So how do you rationalize? On one end you are saying the stocks are declining, but on the other side, your wastage is almost on the order of 80%. So how do you regulate? You need underwater domain awareness. You need to have strict regulation, have a good mapping of the fish stock, and then only you allow consumption. Otherwise, species will get wiped out. So these are issues of, you know, blue economy. When we want to, now what has happened is, earlier there was something called artisanal fishing. The smaller fishermen would go out and fish. They can't fish more than a certain limit. So it was very sustainable. By the time you go again, you know, the fish has grown but today we are talking about mechanized fishing. So when you talk about mechanized fishing, we pick up 200, 300 tons of fish in one go. And that is making it unsustainable. And then the bottom trawling, it destroys the entire ecosystem in one go. And the government is not able to prevent it. So how do you bring in these kind of technologies and this kind of policy interventions so that we can manage the fisheries well? This is the offshore oil rigs that we have. We have a lot of offshore oil, right? They use a lot of acoustic technology. The drills are controlled by acoustics. How do we make it happen? A lot of electronics, a lot of sonar is being used, a lot of acoustics is being used. Now, this is, now, many of you are, you talk about EV. How many of you believe that EV is sustainable? The whole push for EV is that it is sustainable, right? Hydrocarbons are very bad for the environment and EV is sustainable. How many of you think it is sustainable?
No, I cannot feel it. Because even for batteries, you
need
lithium
and iron. But the bigger question is, where do you get the rare, for batteries you need cobalt, magnesium, nickel. You know, these are the four, zinc, you need these rare earth metals. And if the entire global community has to go the EV way, there is not enough that is available on land. are available underwater. Six times more. Okay? Where will you get it? How will you get it? So this is deep ocean mining, deep sea mining. Now, since there is an international organization called the International Seabed Authority, in 1986, India signed up and we were a pioneer in investor in finding out where are these minerals, where are these metals, right? And we have spent millions of dollars to find where it is. But today, the approval exploring has been more or less done. But the exploitation approval is not yet given. So your EV going forward may or may not go very far if resources are not there. But how to make it sustainable? When you do such kind of mining in the water, will it remain sustainable? On 1st of December, a friend of mine from Tokyo University in Jamstek had come to our center in Pune. And Jamstek is at the top end. I mean, they are almost the number one team doing research on such cutting edge things. So they even have ships and AUVs which they deploy up to even 8,000 meters below the surface. What is the deepest point on Earth? Underwater, deepest point?
Mariana
Trench, absolutely correct. It is 11 kilometers, 11 plus point something, 11 kilometers. So, but these Japanese AUVs have a capacity to go up to almost 8,000 meters. They are trying to survey what are the different species that are available at that depth. And if you do these kind of deep sea mining, what will be the effect on the environment? So they are trying to work on different, I mean, that presentation of Tim is available on YouTube. You may just go to our social media site and you can see. Very cutting edge kind of work. But the problem is, you know, they've developed these very pinhole kind of, because see, many are microorganisms. To catch the microorganism, firstly you have to know what is this microorganism, you know, then picture it, go in their natural habitat and then see what they are doing, monitor them. They do three months, four months or six months sailing, and you know, they deploy sensors and all. But the point here is that how much can you prevent? Some effect will be there, but the point is that you have to build a model which can really make sure that the effect is minimum. Are you with me on this? The next is, again, you talk about fisheries. These are, you know, artisanal fisheries. How can we scale up artisanal fisheries rather than going into complete mechanized fisheries, which is not sustainable? This is for the Indian Water Transport. We are doing a lot of dredging, and this is affecting the entire environment. When you do dredging, there is something called a benthic ecosystem. Do you know what is a benthic ecosystem? If you go to a beach, when you walk on the beach, you will see so many living organisms coming out. You must have, many of you must have gone to a beach. There is a complete ecosystem that exists there. And if you just dredge those areas, you will completely destroy that ecosystem, right? And in your environment impact assessment, if that assessment is not done, how do you maintain the ecosystem? So how will you do benthic ecosystem assessment? So we'll discuss that. So similarly, there are a lot of such issues that need to be resolved. Again, you know, I talked about, see, these are a lot of cases of stranding. This is the Fukushima nuclear disaster that happened in Japan. Japan being Japan, they had such amazing systems in place that they could shut down the nuclear plant well in time, because the nuclear plant was damaged, but it was shut down well in time because they had early warning system. See, I am not here to say that we can stop a natural disaster, but with early warning you can definitely minimize the loss of life and property. Don't you think we can have systems which can really, you know, shut down like the way they did? I mean, their entire bullet train system was shut down automatically. Moment they got a warning that there is a tsunami coming, there is going to be destruction. So, with so much, the loss of life and property was minimized. we have 7,500 kilometers of the coastline, we have so many river systems. We have to, now when we do so much of development, when we do so much of construction, we have to have these kind of systems. And it's very easy. Today everybody has a mobile phone. The moment such a thing is come, one SMS can come, and certain instructions can come to what to be done. But somebody has to read through this, somebody has to really be aware of this. So I talked about acoustic habitat degradation. Because, as I said, marine mammals, marine species depend on sound to perceive the environment around them. The moment you do some act, what is the speed of sound in air? Have you thought of it from this side? What is the speed of sound in air? 345 meters per second, right? 345 meters per second. What is the speed of sound underwater?
Less.
1500 meters per second, 5 times more. What is the speed of sound in steel? 5800 meters per second. Sound is a pressure wave. It depends on the directly proportional to the density. So the moment your density increases, but it also has an impact. What is the relation of density and temperature? Is it directly proportional? Increase of temperature will increase density?
No.
Or reduce?
Inverse.
With every degree temperature rise, the speed increases by 4.6 meters per second. Directly proportional. Right? So now in Kharagpasta Lake, when we did our experiment, Kunar temperature in this time, the difference between minimum temperature and maximum was almost to 15 degrees, 20 degrees, right? Are you with me on this? Minimum temperature is about 11, 12 and it goes up to almost 32, right? So what happens if you deploy a sonar in Kharagpasta Lake, what will happen? Your performance will degrade, right? Will change. The speed will increase by 4.6 meters per second per degree. So almost 80 to 90 meters per second difference in the speed of sound. So if you are trying to find the range, what will happen to the result? It will change. If you are deploying it in the morning and if you are deploying it in the evening, it will change or not? Right? So that is the problem in the underwater. With all these parameters changing, the performance of the sonar becomes unreliable. I mean, what I said, in tropical waters, these changes are extremely drastic. So, when you talk about environment also, these kind of things are happening, you know. So, natural disasters can have a lot of effect. One is climate change resilient. I mean, these are all extreme weather events as we say. So, what is climate change? What do you mean by climate change? What is climate change risk? What do you mean? Okay, what do you understand by climate? What is the difference between weather and climate? How do you define climate?
Climate particular region.
Climate is for particular period of time and weather is for a longer duration. Take into account all
other way, other way, other way. Weather is now. Climate is at least 30 years. You take a scale of at least 30 years. So the average temperature or average weather parameter, if they change, then you call it a climate change event, right? And what is climate change risk? What do you understand by climate change risk? What is the risk? Temperature change, you get what?
Disaster. Disaster affects the ecosystem. So this crop and all, everything will change.
Yeah. See, what happens is there's a circulation that happens, right? Mm-hmm. Moment temperature goes beyond a certain things, rains will happen and then the temperature comes down. So weather has its own balance. But this whole cycle that we have winters, we have summer, this is a cycle that has been established in the nature. But it has got a far-reaching effect on the growth of human, of not human life alone, just life. See, humans have evolved. time when you know the resources are abundant so that the infants can survive. By the time they become an adult, you know, even if weather changes, they can withstand. Right? So they, like even the crop, forget about animals, let us talk about crop. You do the sowing at a particular time. Right? We are still dependent on the weather or the climate. Indian agriculture has not got so mechanized or automated that, you know, we can forget about it. So, we are dependent on rain. The first rain must happen and the harvest will happen before the rain, right? So, there is a particular time. Our people in the villages have a far better understanding than most of us in the cities. So, now, the rains must start, like in Pune if you see, the rains must start on the first week of June. Right? And then after the first rain, they do the sowing. Right? Now if, because of climate change, how does rain happen? Because there is a temperature change and a fluctuation. Right? Now instead of June, if the rains comes in July, what happens? Or you need little rain in the beginning so that you know whatever you have sown stabilizes and then the heavy rains can come that it is strong enough to withstand. So if these cycles get disturbed, you'll have complete destruction. Right? And it happens in many, I mean then even animals also depend on that cycle, you know, all that. So now with this climate change, there are very extreme weather events. What are extreme weather events? There will be cyclones, you know, there will be excessive rains. That affects the whole well-being of, like, you see Bombay floods. Everything got destroyed, right? I mean, in one massive rain, what is that? You're not, see, the cities are built to withstand a certain level of rainfall. But if the rainfall is beyond a certain level, the city's infrastructure is not equipped to handle that. And then we have urban flooding. Urban flooding is a very important phenomena that we need to study. Now, what is your thought on how is it important for an electronic engineer? Urban flooding, how does it affect you? Signal processing people, what is your thought? Why am I telling you all this? Out of syllabus. How will you study urban flooding? See, the advantage of a signal processing person is that you are relevant to everything. The highest paid signal processing experts are, you know, where? Where? Any guesses? Highest paid signal processing experts, ka kahan pe utility hai? Stock market. Stock market mein bhi signal hai, no? What is a signal? Any fluctuation, no? And you have to find a pattern within that. Stock market, there are people who do jockeying and they are the highest paid. These are all signal processing people. See, moment you have a digital transformation, whatever it is, moment you have done a digital transformation, what is it? It's just a signal which is changing with time and with space. That's always a signal, right? Anything else? Anybody have a different definition of a signal? Any parameter that changes with time and space is a signal. And what is signal processing? You make sense of the signal. Are you with me?
Yes.
What is the stock market data? It is a prediction based on certain parameters. So if you can apply signal processing there, even when I say climate change, what is climate change modeling? Based on certain parameters of last 100 years, how will it behave in the future? Stochastic modeling, wahi to hota na. Now the problem in climate change modeling is, we did one for the Brahmaputra. What should be the scale of the model? Temporarily, you should at least look at 100 years. Model has to look at 100 years temporarily. I'm talking about climate change modeling. And spatially, kitna hona chahiye? Right from the Himalayas to extra clothing because you know ki in the time that I'm going to come back, there's not going to be drastic changes. What is this? It's a prediction algorithm that you've done, and how have you done it? Based on past experience. So climate change modeling, the same thing. And what is it? It's a signal processing, right? And how do you take it forward? Okay. Now, this is what it is. Science and technology. When you say underwater domain awareness, I gave you example of security, I gave you example of blue economy, I gave you example of environment and disaster management, and now science and technology. What does this signify? Ye kya hai? What is this? What do you need more than this? Ecosystem mapping. What is the ecosystem that exists in our waters? What kind of species are there? What kind of components of ecosystem are there? And how do they interact with each other? Right? Unless you know that, how will you even manage it? How do you regulate? Then what is the second one? What do you see there?
Transportation.
Now, what is the size of the Indian EEZ? What is exclusive economic zone? See, from the coast, 200 nautical miles is our exclusive economic zone. What does it mean? That we as a country, we are allowed to exploit it for our economic benefit. Nobody else can come and use it. Beyond that is international waters. Or some kind. But exclusive economic zone is for us. Now, in the exclusive economic zone, if we have to manage the resources well, we have to have underwater domain awareness. हमको पता होना चाहिए कि क्या चीज़ कहाँ है, क्या है, उसका हम क्या कर सकते हैं. That is what is domain awareness. अगर हमने ये किया तो उसका क्या impact होगा ये हमें पता होना चाहिए. How you do that? You need sensors. ऐसे ही तो करेंगे. We have to have sensors. वो sensor data collect करेगा तो I talk about that in a little more detail. Now, in this area, what is the size of Indian EEZ? 3.1 lakh square kilometers. 3.1 lakh square kilometer में आप कितने sensor डाल सकते हो? Is it viable? So, what will you do? You will use AI. AI को कैसे use करोगे आप? We have to think about it. We will come to that. So, this entire area and sensors कैसे deploy करोगे? ऐसे ही देखते हो पानी में? नहीं हो. There has to be a way. Once the data is collected, it has to come to you. So, we talk about that. So, I just want to give you this example. When I was in Tokyo, I participated in two research cruises. This is the AUV called Urashima. It's a very big AUV, autonomous underwater vehicle. And in this, any researcher, this cruise is controlled by Tokyo University. So, Tokyo University ka koi PhD student hai, koi master student hai, he can put his sensor in this and collect data. Har 3 mahine mein ye jahaz mein jata hai, data collect karke aata hai. So you may go yourself, you may not go yourself. There is a AUV crew, there is a research crew. There's hum log gaye the, we were 15 of us, research crew. So they will, some researchers come on their own and some of them hand over their equipment to us to collect data. And when they come back, we have to give them, data and jo bhi unka kaam tha, we have to faithfully return their equipment and that. So, this is a very different system that they have. And this is a boy that was deployed for 5 years. You imagine a boy with sensors. It has got very high-tech sensors which will collect data at 5 kilometers below the surface. For 5 years, what kind of design, what kind of fail-proof method that has been incorporated to this? This was done by JAMSTEC, the Japanese agency, and this data is collected over 5 years and it is not disturbed because otherwise it will corrupt the data. So these kind of technologies they have developed. Right? I will come into a couple of things little later again. So, this is the UDA nothing will happen. So how all of them can come together and work? And if you look at the vertical construct, how much data do we have of our own? Do you know which all species are there in our waters? Can you Google it and tell me? You cannot. We don't have enough information on what all species exist, what all non-living wealth is available. Kharakpas, aap puna mein rehte hain. Kharakpas ke baare mein kitne ko pata hai? Don't you think it's an asset in our backyard which should be exploited and used effectively? Don't you think there should be a documentation? Don't you think some of us should be working on that? Usko kaise aapke paas resources hain aur aap usko utilize nahi kar rahe hain, to aapko kaun bacha sakta hai? Don't you think we should exploit it? Kharakpas example I'll give you in more detail later. But that will happen only if you understand what it is, right? So what I'm saying is lot of sensing is required. Abhi hum kya kar rahe hain? We're going to the West to tell, ask them कि हमें बताओ क्या करना है. So that's a top-down approach, right? वो ऊपर से हमको बताते हैं, ऐसा आपके पास strategy होना चाहिए, इसको ऐसे करो. But it should be bottom up. हमें, we should understand our condition. A lot of sensing. Once you sense, a lot of analysis, and then the policy. उसको कैसे manage करना? What will the government do? What will the private sector do? What will academia do? Yes or no? So a lot of sending processing here. Lot of instrumentation here. Yes? Lot of data analytics here. Now, this is a multidisciplinary framework. So, the vertical construct, as I say, this has to be a bottom-up approach. Now, what are these smaller cubes?
Hamare कोई भी स्टूडेंट हो, वेदर इट इज अंडर ग्रेजुएट, डिप्लोमा, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट और पीएचडी, एवरीबडी हैज टू डू अ प्रोजेक्ट. व्हाट परसेंटेज ऑफ दैट प्रोजेक्ट सॉल्व्स अ रियल वर्ल्ड प्रॉब्लम? व्हाट परसेंटेज? 5%? 10%? कांट बी मोर देन दैट. डू यू एग्री ऑल ऑफ यू, एवरीबडी इन दिस रूम? डोंट यू थिंक कोई भी हमारा बच्चा प्रोजेक्ट करता है that should solve some real world problem? Yes, I was one of your colleague who came to receive me. I was discussing with him. Even a PhD candidate works on European data or American data. Yes, as if is desh mein koi problem nahi hai. We are all available ki aapke problem hame batao, hum aapke problem solve karenge. Are you? Does it not mean that? Are you with me on this?
Yes.
Anybody disagrees?
We can't blame. I mean, I've been a PhD student, some of you are a PhD student now. Agar humne ye soch liya ki main pura problem solve karunga, field data collect karunga, to hamari zindagi nahi chalegi. We have not been able to build an ecosystem where this data is available. You have to make it modular. Ek BTech student aake apna kaam kare chala jaye. He doesn't have to worry about the larger, but he has to be given a problem where he can make a contribution. Either he makes a contribution in science, in developing science, or he makes a contribution in solving a global problem. There's a difference. What is the difference between the two? Anybody? I said two things. You contribute toward developing science, or you contribute toward real world problem solving. Kya farak hai? जो कि 8000 फीट 8000 मीटर पानी के नीचे जाएंगे, दे विल ट्राई टू स्टडी व्हाट आर द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स देयर, उनका क्या बिहेवियर है. आप सोचो 8000 मीटर पानी के नीचे आपने एक भी भेजा है जहाज वहां पे, और वो करने के लिए आपको कम से कम साल भर का शिप टाइम चाहिए. शिप जाएगा एंड जो ये सब करेगा ही विल पे एटलीस्ट 10 लाख अ मंथ, एटलीस्ट मैं बोल रहा हूं. दे हैव टू बी टॉप साइंटिस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड राइट. व्हाट आर द बजट आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट? इमेजिन आई हैव सेल्ड ऑन दोस शिप्स, इट्स अ 5-star ट्रीटमेंट दैट यू गेट. ठीक है, बट नाउ दीस काइंड ऑफ एप्स, आई मीन उनका इवन उनके जो डिपार्टमेंट्स के नाम है ना, उसको एक्स्ट्रा कटिंग एज टेक्नोलॉजी ऐसे, द नेम्स आर ऑल्सो लाइक दैट. द जापानीज इट्स नॉट कोई मजाक कर रहा है, द नेम इज ऑल्सो एक्स्ट्रा कटिंग एज समथिंग दैट इज डेवलपिंग साइंस. आपको वो चाहिए, जब चाहिए तो चाहिए राइट, बट दैट इज डेवलपिंग साइंस. But what is real world problem solving? अभी हमारे क्या problems हैं? Water quality? आज देखो हम अपने आप को इतने बड़े scientists बोलते हैं, ना तो हम we are able to get the right kind of water to drink, right kind of air to breathe, right kind of food to eat. ये basic problem है ना? बाकी इसको सब extra है ना? Just everything is meaningless. अगर ये नहीं है आप पूरे दिन में ऑडिट करो, इन तीनों चीज के लिए आपके पास कितना टाइम है सोचने के लिए, और कभी आपने सोच के इस पर डिस्कशन किया है? सो वी हैव टू सॉल्व रियल वर्ल्ड प्रॉब्लम्स टुडे, वी आर गोइंग बैक टू बेसिक्स राइट. सो आवर थिंकिंग हैज बिकम एब्सोल्युटली सुपरफिशियल. सो व्हेन आई से इन माय डोमेन ऑफ अंडर वाटर, व्हाट आर द ओशन रिसोर्सेज, आई सेड फिशरीज कितना है, कितने दिन चलेगा, हाउ मच डू वी लीव बिहाइंड, इज इट सस्टेनेबल, हाउ मच आर वी लीविंग फॉर चिल्ड्रन, और कितने जनरेशन बचेंगे इसमें. यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? सो दोज आर रियल वर्ल्ड प्रॉब्लम्स यू हैव टू सॉल्व. सो यू हैव टू मेक अ डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन डेवलपिंग साइंस, साइंस इज ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड. आज लोग एआई की ऐसी बातें करते हैं आप इमेजिन नहीं कर सकते व्हाट पीपल आर टॉकिंग. So that is required. Some people can do that, but majority of the people have to solve. I mean, we are an elite category of people. You all are postgraduate plus, and you know we are all sitting here. We should be able to come out at the end of it that we have solved, or we have at least discussed some real world problem which we would like to solve. Are you with me on this or no?
Yes.
कुछ तो हमें contribute करना है. Then we are wasting our time here. Workshop हो जाएगा, certificate भी मिल जाएगा. क्या बड़ी बात? 10 सर्टिफिकेट आप कलेक्ट कर लोगे, उसका क्या करोगे आप? दिस सर्टिफिकेट इज नॉट गेटिंग यू गोइंग टू गेट यू अ बेटर जॉब, इज नॉट गोइंग टू इंक्रीज योर सैलरी. आर यू विद मी? सो व्हाट रियल वर्ल्ड प्रॉब्लम आर वी सॉल्विंग? सो यू हैव टू मेक अ डिस्टिंक्शन. और मेरी वो औकात है क्या? व्हाई आई एम सेइंग दिस टुडे, इन से इन इंडिया वी डू नॉट हैव द काइंड ऑफ रिसोर्सेज विच जापान हैज. So, when we look at the global community, countries like Japan should go into developing science. And we in India should be looking at solving global problems. Our focus should be to solve global problems. See, this AICT FDP is to discuss these kind of things, according to me. We can't be running our top science. There is enough science which is available to do what we want. Are you with me?
Yes.
So now I am trying to tell you that these molecules are those projects that your and my students should be doing, which will solve some real world problem. Usko kaise karna hai, that we can discuss. We will discuss after this. And dusra, now kids do some project, but then they are said they are not employable because unka koi relevance nahi hai real world se. Now when he job. Any recruiter, whether the security agency से आता है, industry से आता है, he is going to say कि भाई आप मेरे लिए क्या कर सकते हो? Yes? And if he can't answer that question, it makes no sense.
Similarly, blue economy वाले हैं, sustainability,
these are huge markets, इसमें बहुत पैसा है. But our kids are not able to be relevant to them. Are you with me? There are enough funding agencies. आप बोलो मैं climate change के ऊपर काम कर रहा हूँ, मैं sustainability के ऊपर काम कर रहा हूँ. There are international funding agencies which are ready to fund you. But how many of us can make a good proposal which will excite them? Because we have not been thinking of solving real world problems. Tomorrow, you have some dispensable income. कहाँ पैसा लगाएंगे आप? किसको देना चाहेंगे? जो आपको ज्ञान दे रहा है, which has got no relevance on the ground, or somebody who can solve a real world problem. Just put yourself into the same. So we have to be real. We have to talk about what I can do to improve human life or humanity. Right?
Okay. So, I mean, we can go on and on this, but I will move forward. So, abhi, isse pehle wala aapne dekha na.
So, this is a very big thing. Isme bahut sari cheeze aa jati hain.
So, each of them, these smaller cubes that you see here or here.
Firstly, it is multidisciplinary.
Whether if you are a science, a technology student, you can talk about sensors, you can talk about instrumentation, you can talk about various things.
Analysis, computer science ke bache kar sakte hain. If you are a law student, if you are a humanities student, you can talk about policy. So, we invite all kinds of students in our center to come and work with us. Right?
And they can contribute to this whole underworld domain awareness. Going forward,
us bade cube ko
I have made it to a smaller, many such things can be made. Underwater radiated noise framework.
Now, when a ship moves in the water, it generates very low frequency sound. Low frequency means below 1 kilohertz. Right? What is the propagation of sound? Low frequency jyada attenuated hoga ya high frequency jyada attenuated hoga? Jyada attenuated hoga?
Okay, aap log sab electronics ke hain. Resolution versus frequency ka kya relation hai? Inversely proportional hai? आपका रडार अगर हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी का है तो उसका रेजोल्यूशन ज्यादा होगा कम होगा? हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी है तो रेजोल्यूशन कम होगा या ज्यादा होगा? फ्रीक्वेंसी रेजोल्यूशन इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल. हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी है तो वेवलेंथ कम होगा ना. वेवलेंथ एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल, राइट? यस और नो?
यस.
एंड वेवलेंथ इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द रेजोल्यूशन. Right? Acoustic signals are very low frequency. जो audible range है वो 20 to 20 kilohertz है, 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz है. But electromagnetic, RF megahertz में है, gigahertz में है. Right? But RF का range कितना होता है? कम होता है. और वो underwater में तो और भी ज्यादा कम हो जाएगा, localized हो जाता है. Right? So ये जो shipping noise है, in the low, very low frequency, जो 500 हर्ट्ज के नीचे है, दैट ट्रैवल्स ऑलमोस्ट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ किलोमीटर्स. जो बिग वेल्स हैं, ब्राइट वेल्स, दे कम्युनिकेट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ किलोमीटर्स. बट जो डॉल्फिन्स हैं, जो छोटे हैं, बिकॉज नाउ हाउ ओके दैट्स आल्सो एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक. व्हाट इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी और एंटीना साइज में क्या फर्क है, क्या रिलेशन?
फ्रीक्वेंसी इतनी कम हो गया, एंटीना साइज क्या?
अगर बड़ा व्हील है ना तो उसका फ्रीक्वेंसी कम होता है, और छोटा व्हील है तो उसका फ्रीक्वेंसी ज्यादा होता है. बिकॉज फॉर देम टू ट्रांसमिट, उनको भी तो कुछ डिवाइस चाहिए ना, सम फॉर्म ऑफ एंटीना इज रिक्वायर्ड,
राइट? सो जो बिग व्हील्स हैं, विच आर बिग इन size, their frequencies are very small. और जो shipping noise है, उसका भी frequency कम है. तो जो shipping noise है, as we talk, there are 25 million ships that are moving somewhere in the world, not the ones which are anchored or standing. तो 25 million ships और उसका distribution आप देखो, what is the noise that they will be making? और जब से इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन हुआ है 1857 में इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन हुआ था 1859 में उसके बाद शिपिंग ट्रैफिक बढ़ा ही होगा व्हाट इज योर गेस इट हैज इंक्रीज आई गिव यू डेटा 1951 से देयर आर टू स्टेशन जहां पर रेगुलरली डेटा कलेक्शन हो रहा है सो 1951 से द डेटा सेज दैट द शिपिंग नॉइज और द लो फ्रीक्वेंसी नॉइज इन द ओशन हैज डबल्ड एवरी 10 इयर्स Doubling every 10 years मतलब क्या? Acoustic habitat degradation has increased. ठीक है? तो तभी आप जो ये stranding देखा मैंने दिखाया था आपको pictures दिखाया था these strandings are happening in the Indian coast because Indian coast में जो भी shipping बढ़ गया उसको मैं और थोड़ा explain कर दूँगा. Now, so we need to shipping traffic and shipping traffic cannot be reduced because it is directly connected to economic development. तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा problem है. We have built an innovation. We got recognized in 2019. France ko bulaya tha. There is a Narwhal challenge, a marine innovation challenge. We won that. We were invited to France. So, wahan pe humne European Union ne bola ki aap isko international maritime organization mein leke jao. So, main kuch samajh mein nahi aayi ki kya kar raha hai, haan bolu na bolu. But then I realized that, and they said we can teach you there. So, but I realized that it's a Government, which is a part of the IMO, which is a member of IMO, not an individual. So, mera paper, mere naam se nahi ja sakta. Either it can go for Government of India or it can go for European Union. So, then I said, mera paper European Union se kaise jayega? But aapko pata hai, Indian bureaucracy is not so simple, na? Government of India, ek aadmi to nahi hai, na? Government of India is big. Anyway, I was lucky, minister sir mila, jo bhi hua. So, 2021 mein, 1.5 saal lage us pure process ko karne mein. 2021 में हमारा पेपर गया गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया पेपर टू द आईएमओ एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट आईएमओ हैज नाउ नॉमिनेटेड इंडिया एज अ लीड नेशन फॉर अंडरवाटर नॉइज एंड उस एंड दे हैव एलोकेटेड $2 million फॉर इट फॉर दिस स्कूल आई एम नाउ आस्किंग द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया कि आप इसको यू एलोकेट $10 million तो इसको हम बड़ा काम करते हैं नॉट जस्ट व्हाट आईएमओ इज सेइंग बट इसमें कुछ नहीं है मैं बताता हूं हमने क्या किया है व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज अगर ऐसा कुछ काम करना है डिफरेंट स्टेक होल्डर एकॉस्टिक्स करते सेम चीज जो मैं बता रहा हूं मेरा पीएचडी भी इसी काम पे था व्हाट वाज माय पीएचडी कि जो शिप्स और सबमरीन्स का जो रेडिएटेड नॉइज है उसको हम कैसे पैटर्न क्लासिफिकेशन करें पर इसका प्रॉब्लम क्या है सोर्स सिग्नल जब इट प्रोपगेट्स थ्रू द अंडरवाटर डोमेन वो पूरा मॉडिफाई होता है द चैनल यू नो द चैनल पैरामीटर वही act like a filter and wo filter usko modify karega right all of you understand this right to jo signal at source hai convert with the underwater channel parameter then whatever is the noise at the source at the receiver theek hai to I came up with the capsule based techniques and that was my PhD work to usi cheez ko maine navy ke liye kaam kiya because navy mein bhi you want to detect a submarine the same reverse technology hai wahi cheez hai to and बट उसको मैंने लेटर ऑन मैंने इसको एकॉस्टिक हैबिटेट आई रोट अ बुक आल्सो ऑन दिस एंड ये अभी देखिए सेम चीज तीन चार स्टेक होल्डर्स के काम आ रहा है दिस इज व्हाट आई डिड बाय डूइंग माय पीएचडी दिस इज व्हाट आई डिड डूइंग माय पोस्ट डॉक और आई वाज लकी नेवी में रह के आई वाज सिटिंग ऑन अ ह्यूज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर जहां पर बहुत सारा डेटा था एंड आई वाज इंचार्ज ऑफ दैट आई कुड नॉट पब्लिश बट मैंने उसको बहुत I could get a lot of access और मुझे काफी कुछ समझ में आया रियल डेटा में काम किया मैंने नेवी का एक बहुत फैसिलिटी है 20 किलोमीटर इनटू द वाटर हमारे पास 5 सेंसर है और उसमें हम लोग दिन रात डेटा कलेक्ट करते हैं तो उस डेटा को मैंने एनालिसिस करके और वही चीज जहाज के डिजाइन में भी आप उसको कैसे और बेटर कर सकते हो राइट सो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेल यू इज कि ये सारे जो स्टेक होल्डर साथ में आए टू स्पेंड अ लिटिल मनी ऑन रिसर्च तीनों का फायदा होगा सेम चीज है दैट इज व्हाट द अंडरवाटर डोमेन अवेयरनेस इज ऑल अबाउट इसी को अगर हम आगे लेके जाए, अभी देखिए सेडिमेंट मैनेजमेंट, एक तो वाटर रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, अभी आप खड़कवासला डैम को देखिए, खड़कवासला डैम इज 50% सिल्टेड, मतलब क्या बारिश में आप देखते हो, अगर आप जाएंगे खड़कवासला में तो डाउन प्लेन में फ्लडिंग होता है, डैम ओवरफ्लो करता है ना, और उसको खोल भी देते हैं ताकि पानी निकल जाए, एंड ड्यूरिंग ड्राई सीजन आपकी कैपेसिटी रिड्यूस में 50%, तो कई बार होता है ना, दो तीन साल में पुनः में वाटर को राशन करना पड़ता है, बट इट मीन बिकॉज आपने सैनिटेशन को ठीक से नहीं देखा, यू हैव रिड्यूस कैपेसिटी। इसका दूसरा ये भी है, बिकॉज द सैनिटेशन द वाटर लेवल हैज गॉन अप, तो डैम सेफ्टी के लिए भी ठीक नहीं है, डेंजरस है, बिकॉज डैम इज डिजाइन, ये पुराने हो गए ना, खड़कवासला 150 ईयर ओल्ड, तो अगर वाटर लेवल ऊपर होगा तो एवरी 10 मीटर एड्स 1 bar प्रेशर, तो अगर वाटर लेवल ऊपर है तो डैम पे इंपैक्ट आता है और इट इज ऑल्सो डेंजरस फॉर डैम सेफ्टी। सो वॉट इज द सोल्यूशन, वी हैव टू डू डिसिल्टेशन। सो सेडिमेंट मैनेजमेंट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इवन फॉर वाटर रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, ये एक एग्जाम्पल है। दूसरा इंडियन वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट, अभी मैंने आपको ब्रह्मपुत्र का एग्जाम्पल दिया, अगर सेडिमेंटेशन ज्यादा है तो शिप ग्राउंड हो सकता है, नेविगेबिलिटी में प्रॉब्लम आएगा, तो यू विल हैव टू डू व्हाट वी कॉल, पहले तो आपको साउंडिंग करना पड़ेगा और डेलिंग करना पड़ता है। एंड द थर्ड इज डिप्लॉयमेंट अक्रॉस वाटर बॉडीज, अगर आपको जैसे आर्मी को वाटर बॉडीज में टैंक वगैरह को डालना पड़ता है तो यू हैव टू नो द सेडिमेंट बेयरिंग प्रेशर, अगर आपका हेवी व्हीकल उस पर जाता है और वो दब जाता है तो विदाउट पुटिंग इट देयर यू शुड बी एबल टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द सेडिमेंट बेयरिंग प्रेशर, राइट। सो सेम टेक्नोलॉजी, सेम कैपेबिलिटी, ये सब सिटिंग वॉशिंग नहीं है, कुछ नहीं है, आपने एकॉस्टिक साइड स्कैन सोनार या सब वाटर प्रोफाइलर यूज किया, डेटा आया, डेटा एनालिसिस किया और अलग अलग आप यूजर्स को आप डेटा दे सकते हो। That's what we did in this Karatwasa experiment. It's all about city crossing, it's nothing else. But इसमें what are the challenges? आपका जो acoustic behavior वो अलग होगा, दिन में performance अलग होगा, अभी October में आप data collection करेंगे, January में करेंगे, March में करेंगे, उसमें अलग अलग वो आएगा, तो how do you make it robust to the diurnal and seasonal variation? Are you with me on this? So, but what I'm trying to tell you, if somebody works on it, whether as a PhD problem or anything, they are relevant to all these stakeholders that I'm talking about. Har Godavari mein bhi inland water transport ka kaam chal raha hai, Godavari river mein, Khadakwasla mein water resource, Maharashtra mein 3000 such dams are there, pura mein 4000, Maharashtra mein 3000. Aapne agar aisa ek problem solve kiya, it will be very different. I'll talk about this a little more after some time. So now, how much time do we have now? Somebody's teaching us, right?
Now,
13
minutes we have.
13 minutes? Okay, yeah. Okay, so how user academy industry can come together? See, abhi koi naya scheme ki zarurat hai, already Make in India, Skill India, Startup India, Digital India, sab announced hai. There are budgets also for it. Right? And now the blue economy policy, after next Atal AICT ka MVP will be on blue economy also. You can take it written for me. I am part of the blue economy task force of FICCI and we are now, I met the AICT chairman also. So definitely, you know, they'll also see what does AICT do? They look at what the government is looking at in the future and all the programs have to be relevant. Abhi 5G ki bahut baat ho rahi hai, you know, or technology ki bahut baat ho rahi hai, emerging technology ki baat ho rahi hai. So now all these schemes are already there and these are the specific technologies, core capabilities that we need to look at: underwater robotics, semi-processing, modeling, simulation, data science. If all of them come together, and these are the various projects our students or PhD students can take up, right? And what do you get? You get better policy, better technology and innovation, and better capacity building. Now who are the stakeholders who will benefit? Whether the sediment classification, port management, oil and gas industry. So if the students who have done project, whether it is an undergraduate project or a postgraduate project, who are the people they should go for their job? carriers. These are the people. Oil and gas industry, inland transport, water resource management, underwater search and rescue. Ye jada tak Coast Guard or there are some private agencies also who are doing this. Hydrographic survey. Pura inland water transport mein 20,000 kilometers of rivers have to be surveyed. Massive opportunity. Abhi kya ho raha hai? All the Scandinavian countries or the Nordic countries, you can say Norway, Denmark, all these countries, unko project mil raha hai. And obviously, environment impact assessment. So, this is a model we can follow, and a lot of you, whether it's a PhD research topic or postgraduate topic, we can find different problems. So, now, this, as you know, this is a decade of the ocean sciences for sustainable development. UN ne ye wala jo decade hai isko announce kiya hai as decade of the ocean sciences for sustainable development. And under that, what is the tool? Digital transformation in the underwater domain or the marine domain. And what digital transformation ko marine spatial planning bolte hai. What is marine spatial planning? It's nothing but a spatial temporal map. What is spatial? ये आपको इंडिया का मैप दिख रहा है स्पेशली कैसे बिहेव कर रहा है एंड टेम्पोरल मतलब दिस मैप हैज बीन अपडेटेड एवरी 5 मिनट्स ऑलमोस्ट रियल टाइम आपको एप्रिसिएशन अभी आप जैसे यहां पे बैठे हुए हैं ये बॉम्बे हाई में क्या नॉइज है आपको यहां पे पता लग रहा है ये तो खाली अंडर वाटर नॉइज का है फिशरीज अगर आपको एक्वा कल्चर का पता करना है कि कहां पे रिसोर्सेज कहां है अगर आप डीप ओशन मिशन की हम बात करें से मैंगनीज और कोबाल्ट कहां पे कितना है उसका हमें पूरा पता लगेगा सो ये दिस इज जस्ट अ हीट मैप यू नो दिस नथिंग न्यू सो ये आपको पता लग रहा है ये इसमें डीबी स्केल है उसमें वी कैन से व्हाट इज द क्वांटिटी सस्टेनेबिलिटी इंपैक्ट को हम दिखा सकते हैं क्लाइमेट चेंज इंपैक्ट को हम दिखा सकते हैं सो दिस इज द डिफैक्टो टूल फॉर एवरीथिंग एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड मरीन स्पेशल प्लानिंग नथिंग दिस इज जस्ट अ मैप नाउ इसमें लेट मी टेल यू द पॉलिटिक्स गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने पॉन्डिचेरी ऑफ पॉन्डिचेरी और लक्षद्वीप के लिए फिशरीज के लिए दे हैव गिवन अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट टू द नॉर्वे गवर्नमेंट नॉर्वे गवर्नमेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ नॉर्वे नाउ हाउ डू दे एड्रेस इट व्हाट इज द जियोपॉलिटिक्स दैट गोज ऑन उन्होंने ये सब 20 साल 40 साल पहले किया हुआ है बट उनके पास अभी क्या है दे हैव सेंसर्स दे हैव हार्डवेयर राइट यू हैव विद मी उन्होंने बहुत क्वांटिटी में बना लिया है एंड नाउ दे वांट टू मेक मनी दे हैव इन्वेस्टेड राइट दे हैव इन्वेस्टेड टू डेवलप दिस नाउ दे वांट टू मेक मनी तो वो लोग क्या करते हैं बट एज आई टोल्ड यू देयर कंडीशंस एंड आवर कंडीशंस आर डिफरेंट सेम सोना हर पे सेम था नेवी में हमने मैंने बताया 32 नॉटिकल मार दिया यहां पे 7 नॉटिकल मार दे रहे व्हाट दे आर डूइंग दे आर टेकिंग क्रोड्स ऑफ मनी फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड यहां पे उन्होंने सेंसर डिप्लॉय किया यहां अभी आपको अगर इंडियन पोस्ट में फिशरीज का अगर स्टॉक पता करना है आप कितने सेंसर लगा सकते इज दैट द वे ऑफ मरीन स्पेशल प्लानिंग इज इट वायबल इट्स नॉट वायबल सो हम जो विच वी आर सेइंग ये जो मैप हमने बनाया है इसमें अभी तक हमने एक भी सेंसर नहीं डाला देयर इज अभी जैसा आपका गूगल मैप है ना अभी आपका ओला ऐप है और ओला व्हाट डज इट डू पैकेट में गूगल ऐप को ही तो वो यूज करता है व्हाट डज इट डू जैसे आप थिंक दैट समबडी हैज क्रिएटेड है तो ओला के हर जगह जाके मैप करके आपका वो ऐप बनाया क्या नहीं होता सो देयर आर सच टूल्स दैट आर अवेलेबल लाइक गूगल मैप सिमिलरली ओशन में ये जो आप देख रहे हो दैट इज सिस्टम कॉल्ड द ऑटोमेटेड आइडेंटिफिकेशन सिस्टम ये जो 9/11 हुआ था ना यूएस में जब ट्विन टावर बॉम्बिंग हुआ था दैट टाइम द यूएस गवर्नमेंट मेड इट कंपल्सरी फॉर द होल वर्ल्ड की शिपिंग ट्रैफिक जो है इट विल बी मॉनिटर्ड एवरी शिप मोर देन 300 टन्स हैज टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस एआई सिस्टम तो उसका पूरा मॉनिटरिंग होता है वो कहां है क्या है एंड दैट सिस्टम इज कॉल्ड एआई एंड डेटा दैट डेटा इज अवेलेबल तो हमने वो डेटा को यूज करके नाउ वी उसमें एक और दूसरा क्लासिफिकेशन सोसाइटीज है जो अभी आपका अगर एक जहाज है उस जहाज में क्या इक्विपमेंट है एआईएस टेल्स मी कि वो जहाज कहां जा रहा है उसका स्पीड क्या है और जहाज कौन सा है तो There is another database which gives me ki ye particular jar mein kya equipments lage hue hain. And my algorithm needs all this input to find out ki us jar ke speed mein what will be the underwater noise. So what we have done is divided this whole area into smaller grids. 1 lakh long, matlab 11.5 kilometer by 11.5 kilometer ka ya 12 kilometer by 12 kilometer ka grid mein kitne jar hain. That my algorithm calculates and what is the cumulative noise. फिर हम क्या करते हैं दूसरे डेटाबेस में उसका टेम्परेचर सैलिनिटी सारे पैरामीटर्स को लेके अंडरवाटर चैनल को हम सो एक्स इज द शिपिंग नॉइज जो एच है यू ऑल रिमेंबर एक्स कन्वोल्यूशन एच प्लस डब्ल्यू इज वाई राइट ओके रिमेंबर सो एक्स इज द अंडरवाटर नॉइज विच इज जनरेटेड बाय द शिप एंड जो उसका व्हेन इट प्रोपगेट्स अंडरवाटर That is calculated, H is calculated by another algorithm, which is the underwater channel, the channel parameters you are there. And with that, also we have calculated the noise. And you get this map according to that. So once we have done this, this is a modeling, right? This is a modeling and simulation effort. And this is what we have critical areas we have validated here. With couple of such iterations, my faith in the model will become very good. Yes or no? तो अभी मैं पूरे इस एरिया को पॉपुलेट कर सकता हूं यूजिंग दिस सो ये जस्ट एक एप्लीकेशन है देयर आर सच वेरियस अभी आप सेडिमेंट फ्लो आप जब देखते हैं देयर आर एल्गोरिथम्स लाइक दैट वी हैव यूज्ड दैट सो उसको हम यूज करके वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड कि उसका सेडिमेंट ट्रांसपोर्ट फ्लो कैसे होगा या जो हमने खड़कवासला में किया एकुस्टिक्स को यूज करके व्हाट शुड बी द सेडिमेंट बेयरिंग प्रेशर वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड दैट तो ये हर एप्लीकेशन का एमएसपी बन सकता है सो दिस मेथड इज वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट सो आई थिंक आई विल स्किप दिस वी डोंट हैव मच टाइम नाउ तो इसमें कम्युनिटी के लिए हैबिटेट मैपिंग स्पीशीज मैपिंग रिसोर्स मैपिंग वल्नरेबिलिटी असेसमेंट एमएसपी बेस्ड लाइवलीहुड मैपिंग अभी क्लाइमेट चेंज से लाइवलीहुड में कितना फर्क पड़ेगा विद 2 डिग्री क्लाइमेट चेंज लार्जली मेजर अभी जो पैरिस समिट के बाद लोग ये सोच रहे हैं कि 1.5 डिग्री टेम्परेचर चेंज को हमें कम करना है इन द नेक्स्ट 10 इयर्स और वी सेड 2070 राइट तो उसको भी मैपिंग उससे क्या फर्क पड़ेगा अगर 1 डिग्री टेम्परेचर बढ़ा ग्लोबल टेम्परेचर क्लाइमेट चेंज इंपैक्ट है उससे क्या फर्क पड़ेगा कोरल्स पे क्या इंपैक्ट आएगा श्रिम्प फार्मिंग में कितना इंपैक्ट आएगा ऑल दैट मैपिंग हैज टू बी डन And this is what is the MSP.